Hello and welcome to our special edition of Music Discoveries. Today, our guest is my dear friend, Yelena Kurdina. Hello, Yelena.
Hello, Monica.
She is an extraordinary pianist, vocal coach, prompter, and assistant conductor at the Metropolitan Opera. For over 25 years of her career, she worked with the most outstanding singers of our time, including Placido Domingo, René Fleming, Dimitri Hvorostovsky, Elena Obraztsova, and many others. She plays a very important part in singers' development. What makes a great singer is to have an excellent vocal coach and pianist who can work with you on correct notes, musical phrasing, and correct pronunciation. In other words, great vocal coach is always behind a great singer. Today, we will talk about her career and about her experiences of working with these important singers of our time. So, Yelena, how come you became so famous?
That's a very complicated question. By staying in the business.
You came here from St. Petersburg, I understand.
Well, we immigrated like many Jews. Immigrated and I came with my family. I came to St. Louis and went to school there. Finished my bachelor's. Studied vocal accompanying and coaching with John Wustman. So I studied with him for 3 years and I got my master's and then I went to New York and studied at the bottom. I mean, started at the bottom. I played for voice lessons. I accompanied auditions. I started coaching singers little by little. And then a few years after moving to New York, I started working at the Met.
So one of the most exciting work you had was with the big star of the opera that everybody knows, famous tenor, Placido Domingo. You became his private coach for his preparation of the one of the most important roles of his career, which is German in The Queen of Spades. Please tell us a little bit about this experience.
I coached him. He learned the Queen of Spades with me. We worked very, very hard for a year. And for many hours, you know, I had to teach him from the very, very beginning, notes, words, pronunciation, phrasing. He was 58 when he did it. So it was harder for him, you know, I mean, Russian, which he didn't speak. Was difficult, but memorizing, of course, was the most difficult part. And so he did a great job. And so I got to travel with him. First, he did it at the Met, and then he went to Vienna to do it at the Vienna Staatsoper. So I got to go there. And then they did the production in both Los Angeles and Washington.
Я не знаю.
also work with one of the most significant American soprano, Renee Fleming, on the production of Eugene Onegin for PBS station. And you developed your own technique to teach them?
No, not really. I developed my own way of transliterating the paper, you know, but not a particular way of teaching. No, it depends on the person. It really does. Some people have natural talent for that, and it's easier for them.
You also collaborated on stage with Dimitri Hvorostovsky, playing for him many recitals. Please tell us, how was it?
Well, it was fantastic with Hvorostovsky. I mean, I didn't really coach him. I accompanied him in several recitals. It was wonderful. We would rehearse once and we would do it. We didn't have to discuss anything. It was easy and inspiring and exciting. Mm-hmm. He was fantastic.
There's another great Russian singer that you collaborated with, my favorite mezzo-soprano, Elena Obraztsova.
Obraztsova I met at the end of her career, pretty much. She was the inspiration, actually, when I was very young, and I happened to come to her recital just by mistake, thinking I was going to someone else's concert. And I just loved her singing and her personality. And so I started listening and going to concerts and going to opera. So she was the initial inspiration for me going into vocal accompanying. And I met her in 2001 at the Metropolitan Opera when she came to do some smaller parts. And then ended up also accompanying her in a couple of recitals and coaching her in some things and just going through repertoire.
Yeah,
Yeah, she was a wonderful spiritual person, interesting person, inspiring, exciting, funny. So it was, I mean, what can I say? It was great to play for these people. It was really, really fabulous.
I must say that I also had a chance to work with you, performing many recitals. You also prepared me to sing an operatic part, which is Princess Marina, Polish Princess Marina, from Boris Godunov.
Oh, I did.
Here's the fragment from Boris Godunov by Mussorgsky. So what is your favorite opera?
Well, Queen of Spades, I suppose, but only because that was the first opera I listened to, the first opera I saw live, and an opera that really gave me a lot of interesting experiences. You know, my favorite operas are not necessarily something that is musically the most interesting to me, but experiences I had while working on these operas. So it's not, but you know, I love Otello. I love Traviata. But I mean, you know, it's impossible because any great opera, I mean, if I say it's Otello, then what do you do with Traviata and Cavalleria Rusticana and Manon Lescaut? I mean, which one? I don't know.
So working for so many years at the Metropolitan Opera and also other opera houses in the world, do you have any memories, any specific stories, any funny memories that you can tell us?
Well, yeah, I have a funny story about War and Peace. Mm-hmm. When I was prompting, so there was a scene with the tenor and I start prompting and I don't hear anything. So, oh my God, he didn't come in. He can't hear me. So nothing. Well, turns out he never came on stage. it was a very complicated production and a lot of people. And so there were entrances onto the stage that are not usually used. And so he decided to come from a different door, and the door was locked. And so he got lost.
Oh my gosh.
He wasn't there. So something like this, and, you know, a couple of similar things when people just didn't show up on stage. Basically, when you're working on stage, you're so busy, you don't really notice funny things.
Mm-hmm. You work on many aspects of the opera, and then you also prompt it. So how is it different? Is it difficult to prompt? Because some singers really count on you. How is it?
Well, you know, I find that a prompter is like a security blanket. You're there just in case something happens, or to give a singer some extra reassurance. It's rarely about words. It's more about cueing people in and saying, yes, that's your time. Now it's your time. Now it's you. Mm-hmm. Stage is very complicated, and, you know, there's a lot of noise. There are a lot of people. It's easy not to hear something, maybe turn around, not see the conductor. So a prompter is always focused on singers. Mm-hmm. So is it difficult? No, I don't find it difficult, because you kind of grow into it when you coach and you know the music very well, and you coach people, you sing entrances, you cue them.
So basically, you have to know opera very well, and you have to know the staging, you have to know the words, you have to know the music, you have to know everything.
Well, of course. But we have a score in front of us, so I need to know it, but I don't need to memorize it.
I also know that your passion lies in Spanish music. How come?
I have no explanation. I find it very interesting, the rhythms, the colors, mm-hmm. the passion of it. I like the sound of the language as well.
So here's the fragment of our recital,
El Vito
by Obradors. Also work with a lot of young singers at this very famous festival.
Institute for Young Dramatic Voices, run by Delora Zajic. Delora does auditions and brings a lot of very interesting young voices. And in the summer, we have a three-week program where we coach everybody and have a performance at the end. And there are all kinds of levels of singers, you know, from very young to intermediate to young professionals and to people who are in the career but need some polishing.
What are your other passions besides music?
A little bit of computers, making websites. I like doing that. And that's my little hobby.
Please look it up. She made my website too, and hers very beautiful, and other people, famous people. So what are you doing in this time of pandemia?
I'm doing nothing, really.
You're studying some music. Do you miss music?
I listen to a lot of music.
So you're not doing a lot of music online, virtual concerts?
The online music making is extremely non-satisfying. You lose the spirit online. And I hope that we get to do a live concert soon. And anybody who's watching us speak today comes to the concert.
please,
or any concerts.
Please, we can't wait to go back on stage and to perform. And I would like to thank you, my dear friend, Yelena Kurdina, for being here with us and for sharing your experiences of working with great operatic singers. Now I think we know, and the audience understands how important for a singer is to have a vocal, excellent vocal coach and pianist who can help you in the process of learning. And I hope to see you soon and to perform with you soon.
Thank you for inviting me.
Goodbye.
Bye.